Let's get the latest on that civil case against Prince Andrew in the US. And as we mentioned earlier, a federal judge has ruled overnight that it may go ahead. Barbara Miller is following the developments from Washington. She joins us now. What's the ruling, Barbara?
Well, it's a 46-page ruling, Madeline. This is in response to legal arguments that were heard just over a week ago in a New York court, where Prince Andrew's lawyers were attempting to say that a 2009 agreement between Virginia Giuffre and financier Jeffrey Epstein essentially protected Prince Andrew from prosecution. Now, Virginia Giuffre alleges that Epstein trafficked her to the prince when she was 17 years old on three occasions in London, New York and in the US Virgin Islands on Epstein's private island. The judge has resoundingly rejected the motion to dismiss the case based on that 2009 agreement. In the detail of the ruling, he says that it's not that he says that that agreement definitely doesn't protect Prince Andrew, but that it's ambiguous and that it would have to be determined by a jury whether or not it protects him. But that was the prince's, I think, best chance of getting this civil case dismissed, and that has failed.
As you say, it is a civil case, not a criminal case. What does it mean for the prince now?
Well, he has a few options. One would be to default on the case, simply not to engage with it. That would seem extraordinary, but he could go down that path. Then the court would decide the case and he would potentially have to pay Virginia Giuffre damages. He could let it go to trial, and there's already a timetable for trial. That would be trial in the latter half of this year. Now, again, that would seem extraordinary, that the Queen's son would appear before a jury, and before that, he would be obliged to give Virginia Giuffre's lawyers an interview in what's called a deposition. They'd be grilling him about some of the claims he made in that infamous BBC interview, for example, that he couldn't sweat, that he'd absolutely no recollection of ever meeting Virginia Giuffre. So the third option is that he settles the case with Virginia Giuffre, that the two parties agree on some sum of money to be paid to settle this civil case. I spoke to a New York lawyer and former prosecutor, and he outlined some of the issues involved in that route.
The people around the prince have said until very recently he wasn't interested at all in a settlement. Now they have changed their tune and they've said he's considering a settlement. On the other hand, prior to the motion to dismiss being argued, David Boies publicly stated that Virginia Giuffre Roberts had wanted to engage in settlement discussions, but Prince Andrew had refused. And now he has said, the attorney for the plaintiff has said that his client is not interested in a settlement unless it includes a public apology.
And David Boies, Virginia Giuffre's lawyer, has given an interview to Sky News saying that she is pleased with the outcome. There has been no reaction or no comment from Buckingham Palace, except to say, as they've said all along, that they will not comment on what's an ongoing legal matter.
Some very difficult decisions for Prince Andrew there. Barbara, thank you.